Tim Sherwood. Number 10, skipper Teddy Sheringham. Number 14, just Poyet. Number 16, Steffen Iversen. Number 26, Lenny King. Number 29, Simon Davis. And number 30, Anthony Gardner. First substitutes this evening, number 32, Gavin Kelly. Number 11, Servo Rivera. Number 17, Ivan Leonalta. Number 28, Matthew Etherington. Number 31, Orton Phil.
White Hart Lane for this second leg semi-final tie. Chelsea have the advantage after winning the first leg 2-1. Jimmy Floyd Hasselbaink scoring both goals for Chelsea. There's Ferdinand, who is missing tonight, scoring for Tottenham. Away goals will count, but only after extra time. It's been a wet day here in North London. The pitch is going to be slippery. The atmosphere is red hot and it is absolutely electric on the terraces. Referee Mark Horsley throws the whistle and we're up and underway. Ball goes out of play, straight away for a throw into Tottenham. You don't need me to detail Tottenham's recent record against Chelsea, but I will anyway. Just for the record, this is the 27th game and hopefully it'll be Tottenham's first victory in those 27 games. So Anthony Gardner's on the ball, plays the long cut out there in the at the back by Chelsea. Tirico. Tottenham win an early free kick. Tirico winning the free kick there. Glenn Hoddle in his programme notes this evening has urged the supporters to be the difference. And they've started doing their bit in the opening minutes here this evening. Stanic playing it out of play. Tottenham have a throw. Croatian international with over 35 caps to his name. Perry plays it safe all the way back to goalkeeper Sullivan. Ball gets played long. Sheringham wins a header. That's Poyet. Back to King. Poyet out to Davis. Not the best of clearances there by Chelsea. Anderson in the middle. Sherwood. By Zenden. Joined Chelsea in the summer for £7.5 million from Barcelona. Sheringham dummies it, has Tirico in space on the edge of the box. Tirico, good save there by Kudicini, and it's gone in. Steffen Iversen gets the rebound. That's the perfect start for Tottenham. Only 1 minute on the clock and it's all square. The ground has erupted to a cauldron of noise. Teddy Sheringham. Chirico broke. The shot came in. Great save by Cudicini. Steffen Iversen from the edge of the six-yard box. The perfect start for Tottenham. Well, that's absolutely amazing. Iversen from 6 yards. He's not going to miss from there. Only his second goal of the season. The first also came in the Worthington Cup. Well, we have a game on our hands. That's just what Ben Hoddle wanted. Well, the crowd have come to their feet. They've come to life. John Terry plays it back to Cudicini. Well, just as I was about to say, what a great season Cudicini's having. Rebound from the save came out, and Steffen Iversen made no mistake. Ranieri with a very solemn look on his face. Early days, of course. Outside to Tirico again. Tirico cuts into the box. Gets past Stanic, gets the cross in. There's Iversen again, overhead kick. Header comes in. Blocked. Chelsea clear. Delas with a clearance. Stays like this, Tottenham will go through, albeit after extra time. Ben Hoddle's blue and white army is the crowd, is the shout from the crowd. Well, Stanic has gone down, a bit of archers there, not happy with the challenge on him. Tirico, to be fair, was a little bit high on the leg. Chelsea do win the free kick. Tirico was in trouble earlier on in the season at Everton with a challenge on Gravesen. Hopefully that's all behind him.
Clearance.
was stuck in traffic or stuck on the trains coming from work. Not the best of starts to miss, to be honest with them, but never mind. Play over the header back, Sullivan will come out, collect safely. Decides to play it long. Zenden. Long ball forward. Another running onto that one, far too strong. Anthony Gardner. Sherry, long good ball back there to Poyet. No free kick there. Hasselbaink. Hasselbaink. Referee said it comes off Gardner for a corner.
Back off Hasselbaink or stand!
Hasselbaink getting booed, probably for the penalty that was awarded for him in the league game here in September. We'll take the corner. No chops up from the back. Referee says wait for the whistle. That's now gone. Corner comes in. Iversen with the header out. Teddy Sheringham has Davis ahead of him. Did get there first. Bit of a two-footed challenge there, it seems, on Zenden. Zenden has stayed down. No manage there, Sheringham did play the ball. Clearly played the ball, Teddy Sheringham. Didn't make contact with Zenden, but as I said, no manage whatsoever. Well, the stretch is coming on for Zenden. Not too sure if that's a precaution or whether it will be a substitution. Poyet. Sheringham, good ball back to Sherwood. Finds Tirico. Well, Tottenham certainly started a brighter. Good ball to Gardner. Corner ball, Tottenham's first of the game. We're just hearing that Zenden has a gash on the top of his leg. That's why he's gone off. So Anderson will take the corner. Big men are up, corner comes in, Gardner with a flick on! Oh! Right across the face of goal. The faintest of touches at the far post would have seen Tottenham go 2-0 up on the night. As it is, the corner came in, Gardner with a flick on there. No one at the far post. Chelsea escape. First fans with good voice. Johnson, it's his first touch, I think. Anderson, inside to Sherwood. Sherwood's back in the team as he came on the injured Steffen Iversen in the first leg. Done well since then, Tim Sherwood. Second lovely throw. Coming over. Poyet. Back to King. Not too much open to him. Good ball inside to Darren Anderson. Played there by Gus Poyet. Sheringham. Davis outside him. Good ball find Simon Davis. Just ran too strong. Davis keeps it in. Tried to win the corner off Dallas. Wasn't successful. Simon Davis had a great game here on Saturday against Everton. Behind that goal, going to make him the most noise. Sherwood sets a little ball finding Iversen. Good clearance by Terry. To his name. Lampard. Johnson back to Melfield. Lampard again, only as far as Tirico, he is. Iversen wins ahead. A good header back by Steffen Iversen. Season. Must surely feature in Sven Göran Eriksson's plans for the summer. Phenomenal strike record, this is Jimmy Floyd Hasselbaink. Woeful couldn't keep it in, so Tottenham will have the throw. Steffen Iversen gives chase. And Terry will try and bring under control, and he does. Mark Halsey goes up. John Terry's been in the news recently for all the wrong reasons. His arm was across Iversen there, pulling his shirt slightly. For Johnson, into header, finds Hasselbaink. Good header out to Stanich. Game stopped again. Hopefully the referee will allow the game to flow more than he's done in the last few minutes. Just so he comes up from the back. Scored the very late winner here in the league in September. Free kick comes in. Sullivan will come back to punch. Makes contact. And the free kick goes against Chelsea. Sullivan came in, the free kick was against Stanich for colliding with the goalkeeper. Must admit, it really wasn't Stanich's fault, but there you go, decision's been made. Done. Back to Perry. So is it vital now for Tottenham to keep a clean sheet? Stating the obvious perhaps, but it had to be said. Darren Anderson keeps it in. Tirico's done well. Back to Doug. Sheringham. Poyet just couldn't control it there. Chelsea break. King has to be careful. Can't give Hasselbaink any space. Did well there, Emily King. So impressive at the centre of the defence for Tottenham this season. Ball for King, the Viking. Iversen was under control. Snapshot comes off John Terry for the corner. Brought it down well, Steffen Iversen, as the ball came forward. Didn't have much time. Brought it down. First time shot blocked by John Terry. Good start by Steffen Iversen, who's coming for this Ferdinand. Anderson with the corner. Comes in. Iversen at the far post, didn't get a true contact on that. Good well to find his space now, Iversen. I kind of fell between him and Poyet. Well, that goal early on in the game wasn't Iversen's first goal in the Worthington Cup semi-final for Tottenham. Of course, he scored the winner in 99 against Wimbledon, which saw us get to Wembley. Climbing over the defender there. halfway through the first half. Tottenham had the lead through Steffen Iversen in the first minute.
Inside,
forced out wide to Anderson. Davis gives the ball back to Anderson. Doesn't have many in the box. Melchior with a header clear. The team will take the ball out of defence. Stanic.
Shot! Goal! The
save there by Cudicini. Great shot by Gaspoyet on the edge of the box. And an even better save by Cudicini. He's so alert, Gaspoyet. Doesn't need much space. Cracking save. Just as it was going into the roof of the net. Well, Gaspoyet playing against his old team. Has played against Chelsea in another semi-final. Back in the Cup Winners' Cup in 95 for Real Zaragoza. Low corner this time. Shot comes in, it's gone in! Tim Sherwood has doubled Tottenham's lead! His first goal of the season! The old Tottenham low corner! Hoddle is delighted! And the crowd are too! Low corner! Sherwood turns! Roof of the net, it fails! Tottenham have the lead on the night by 2-0! And for the first time in the tie, the lead on aggregate! Cracking shot, caught it first time! Gave Cudicini absolutely no chance! Well, that certainly has brought the crowd back to their feet. Amazing first half here for Tottenham. Tottenham need to be controlled and composed at the back. The Johnson has the ball on the edge of the box, gets the shot in, goes wide. Well, the Johnson normally doesn't leave many chances from that kind of range. Controlled it, had the shot. Wasn't too far wide, to be honest. Well, this is dream stuff for Tottenham. Tim Sherwood scoring his first goal of the season, as I said. Anderson in the box. Just couldn't keep it in play. Well, that's Sherwood's 16th goal for Tottenham. And this is his 101st appearance for the club. Well, I've never seen the Chelsea fans as quiet as this as long as I've been coming to White Hart Lane. Sheringham. Gus Poyet. Ball played there by Iversen. Cross comes in. Well, all the pressure's coming from Tottenham. 10 minutes to half time. Davies has a long throw. The big men aren't going up from the back for this throw. Poyet more than likely to be the target. Sherwood was just lining up for the shot there as Poyet took it off him. Not great, Tim Sherwood. Shot against the wall. Taylor Bonner with the ball forward. The referee indicates that Stanic was pulling the shirt there. Well, the atmosphere is absolutely amazing here this evening. Spurs fans in all stands are up, including the traditionally quiet West End.
Stoppage. Once again, Chelsea had the ball anyway. Referee
frustrating when the game's got like this consistently. It's absolutely vital for Tottenham to keep a clean sheet before half time. Last 3 minutes of the first half. Free kick comes in. Iversen clears.
Thank you.
Zenden in no hurry to take the kick. Referee checks his watch. Showing him with a knock on. Davis plays it forward to Sheringham. To the box, cut back to Poyet with a header. Oh, unlucky there, Gus Poyet. Desperate to score against his old club. Sheringham with a pull back. To be fair, Cudicini had the near post covered anyway. First half for Tottenham. Steffen Iversen gave Spurs the lead after a minute. Good to see Steffen Iversen back amongst the goals. Tim Sherwood doubled that lead. The cracking shot from the edge of the penalty area. Tottenham have the lead 2-0 on the night. 3-2 on aggregate. So here we go for the second half. No substitutions by the team at half-time. Zenden, we understand, will be going to hospital later on this evening for stitches on that gash. I'm sure Ben Hoddle will be same at half-time. Keep your composure, there's still a job of work to be done. As a reminder, it's 3-2 on aggregate at the moment to Tottenham. Spurs are 45 minutes from the park. We're up and running for the second half. Wins an early free kick. We've seen many times in these games that the half-time whistle can affect the team that had the advantage in the first half. Tottenham will, of course, be hoping that doesn't happen this evening. John Terry. Johnson. Out to Stanich. Good challenge there at the back. Dennis. Petit. Inside to Sam Dalabona. And John Terry. Hasselbaink was a bit strong. Gianfranco's overlooked some from the bench. He will be figuring out some point in the second half. Gardner with a clearance. Iversen. Esso wins the ball. Nice hand pass. Plays it forward to Iversen. Well played there by Darren Anderson. Good skip over the ball. Side decision has been given. Stanich. two in the opening minute here. Booking against Gus Poyet. He will be booked for his troubles as well. No one from behind. Can't really argue with that one. You see just how heavy the rain is coming down here still. Short. Let's see, chips the ball into the box. Gardner with the clearance. Balabana inside to Frank Lampard. Iversen, Tottenham have a chance for the counter-attack. Poyet is by himself. That heels it to Anderson. Good ball outside to Simon Davies. He's in space. Davies had the right, goes for the shot. No real power to be honest, and Fidicini collected it safely. He needed to as well, as Gus Poyet was following up for the rebound. Tottenham have the free kick. Good shot there by Simon Davies. It's always worth getting the long shots in, especially on the wet, slippery surface like we have tonight. To be fair, it wasn't the best of contacts, but well worth the effort anyway. Tottenham's first shot of the second half. Sheringham needs some support. There's Anderson inside, just to what's coming up for him. Lampard collects and wins a free kick. That's the back helps it on. I think that came off Stanic. Referee disagreed. Yes, I am. Sullivan had a good clearance. Showing him wins a header as well. Finds Tarico outside him. Poyet's in space in the middle. He's calling for the ball. As it is, he uses Anderton. Poyet still in space, that's the ball in. Back with the box to Sheringham. What a cracking shot by Teddy Sheringham. Sheringham from the edge of the box. Makes it 3-0 on the night. Gave Cudicini absolutely no chance. Sheringham's seventh goal of the season. His first goal since the game against Bolton in December the 3rd. First time outside of his right foot. Cudicini may have got a touch on that. Well, the game seems to be going Tottenham's way. Teddy Sheringham, what a sweet contact there. Bang! Great goal from Sheringham. Well, the crowd senses it's going to be a great night. The smile from Sheringham says it all. The atmosphere here is absolutely electric. That's the perfect start for the second half. Just what Hoddle would have wanted. And Tottenham break again. Sherwood tries to find Iversen. Geddes with a heady clearance. Only as far as Gustavo Poyet. Gets the ball into the box. No accuracy on the cross. Well, Ken Bates doesn't look happy. The Spurs fans are absolutely buoyant. Glenn Hoddle's blue and white army is the cry. Spurs have been 3-0 up at home this season and thrown it away. Spurs fans will be hoping that's not going to happen again. Clearance by Desailly. Desailly's won a lot in his career. Won the World Cup, won the European Championships. Iversen. Sheringham's in space. Does well there, Teddy Sheringham, has Tarico behind him. Well, there's a special atmosphere on Cup Nights at White Hart Lane. There's a special atmosphere brewing here this evening. All that's missing is the white shorts. And the Glory Glory Knights could be back. Bella Bonner finds Gallas. I can barely hear myself, let alone anybody else here this evening. He'll take good ball forward. Sullivan's out. Does well then, Neil Sullivan, to come out. The offside flag is up anyway. Well, the crowd of Worthington Hasselbaink, in total fairness to him, he did pull out of the challenge and he got himself a kick on the arm and a ripped shirt for his troubles. All forward by Gardner. Finds Tirico, who needs some support. Only just to keep it on. No, he doesn't. Well, the job's far from done. They have the all-important two-goal cushion on aggregate. Outside to Stanich. It's Hasselbaink in the box, Andrew Johnson and Petit. Tirico does well to leave it. Teddy Sheringham saying it was a push in the face, it clearly was, but it was the wrong man. He's saying he pushed him in the face and he's booking Sheringham now. Well, Sheringham was trying to protest the innocence of Hasselbaink. Getting himself booked, well that's absolutely extraordinary. I've never seen that before. Well, we have to say the referee seems to have lost control here. Hasselbaink is walking off. It was the wrong man. See there the push clearly from Melchior. Hasselbaink, in fairness to him, is telling Melchior to calm down. Well, the game's up and running again. Chelsea are down to 10 men. They're 3-0 down on the night. You could say it's not going their way. Mario Melchiot is a very lucky man indeed. I'm sure with video evidence, Hasselbaink will be cleared. I can still see in the tunnel there, he's still arguing. The police are over with him. But anyway, the game's underway, so we'll concentrate on that. Hasselbaink still in the tunnel. Having words with the policeman now. Chelsea have a throw. The Johnson falls to the ground. And Frank Lampard got himself sent off in the league game here in injury time. Over the best part of half an hour to go. Hasselbaink's been sent off. Interception there by Tirico. And there's a foul there from behind by Melchiot. Now he's got away with it once. Alistair Beattie comes running on to see to Tirico. Now what's the referee going to do here? Well, that was late. He went back for more as well. He lifted his foot. It's been in the wars tonight, Tirico. Got an elbow in the face in the first half. He's got sore ankles now. Melchiot's been called over, he's apologising to Tirico. Tirico is shaking his hand. All eyes on the referee to see what card it's going to be. I think it's only going to be yellow. Well, Melchiot should have been sent off a couple of moments ago. Poyet, Tim Sherwood, is that Anderson outside him? Intercepted by Stanic, let's see. The ball outside, finding Stanic. Sheringham is in space. Forsell. Back to Gudjonsson. Perry with a clearance.
Too many fingernails left to chew.
Poyet. John Terry lines up the shot. Comes off the backside of Chris Perry. Very optimistic to have a shot from a full 40 yards. As it is, it produces a corner for Chelsea. The goal now for Chelsea. We've already thrown the cat amongst the pigeons. Thrown over the corner. Chelsea 7. Sullivan comes out. Scottish international makes no mistake in the pitch. Huge goal kick. Straight to his closing goalkeeper. Desai. Interception yet again by Simon Davis. Another contender for man of the match. Anderson may just be edging him today.
Fans are empty.
Their section is totally deserted. Either that or they've all taken their coats off to reveal their blue shirts. But I think it's blue seats. Anyway, back to the action. This is Thatcher, was still Prime Minister when Tottenham last beat Chelsea. The supporters there are absolutely loving it. I've seen Tottenham throw away some leads, but surely not tonight. Steffen Iversen! Teddy Sheringham! Well, my voice is nearly gone, and there's still 13 minutes to talk you through. Johnson with the shot. Well, there's going to be a party on the terraces tonight. Poyet outside to Tirico. Could there be more? Could Tirico get his first goal for Tottenham? Delighted looking down there. His face hasn't cracked, but inside him he'll be jumping up and down for joy. Ranieri, on the other hand, the emotions couldn't be further from what Hoddle's thinking. Oh dear. And Tottenham break again. Could there be more? Anderton. Well, 12 years of hurt, it's all gone tonight. Cross comes in. Looking for another omen there at Gus Poyet. Poyet, as I said before, played against Chelsea in the semi-final for El Zaragoza, and they went on to win it that year. And in case you're in any doubt, that's the Chelsea fans leaving. Finds Zola. shot. I think the phrase is, I'll go. Worth a shot. Full 25 yards out. And a good 6 yards wide. Well, Tottenham make their first substitution. Steffen Iversen, who's got the opening goal for Tottenham, is going off. Sergio Redbrook comes on. He will have a full 8 minutes. And Gus Poyet is going off as well. And Ivan Leonardson is coming on. Poyet is absolutely delighted. Look at that jump. Well, if there's any doubt as to where his allegiances lie now, that said it all. Embraced by his manager. Leonardson had a superb game here on Saturday against Everton. Oh, look at that smile. He's absolutely delighted. Look at him. Wow. Great to see. The Spurs fans are singing Poyet's name. Tottenham break again. Sheringham's offside. Fans will be staying behind for some time to enjoy the moment. Rebel doesn't quite know where he is. To be honest, I've got to pinch myself as well. 5-0 against Chelsea. Two and a half minutes to the regulation 90. Anderson dispossesses Lerabona.
Inside the final 2 minutes of stoppage time.
Tottenham break again through Teddy Sheringham. The 6-3 is the aggregate score, as was the other semi-final changing yesterday. Blackburn, of course, beating Spurs old boy Terry Orr's side. On the referee for the final whistle. Have to wait a moment or so longer. And Tottenham break again. Lots of space. Leonardson has Sergei Reprov in the middle. Simon Davis breaks on the other flank. Reprov looks up, checks inside. Has Anderton inside him. Anderton now gets the ball. Intercepted by John Terry. And Sherwood tracks back. The old legs did well there, did Tim Sherwood. All eyes on the referee. It's going to be any moment now, and wait for the crowd to absolutely erupt at the final whistle. Or Tirico's down with cramp. Gantry up here is absolutely rocking through the vibrations of the fans all around the ground, jumping up and down in their seats. Any second now the whistle's going to blow. Free kick. Simon Davis breaks. Sheringham's inside. Time for one more goal perhaps. Ian Arthur's made the run. Simon Davis gets the ball. Sheringham goes straight to the back post, cross comes in. Desai with a header clear. And that's it! It's all over! Spurs have done it! 5-1 on the night, Hoddle celebrates! Absolutely amazing scenes here at White Hart Lane. Simon Davis, arguably man of the match, salutes the crowd. It was Sergei Reprov that got the fifth and final goal. Sherwood got the second goal with a cracking volley from the edge of the box. Sheringham got the vital third goal. A real captain's performance tonight from him. Well, from February 1990 to January 2002, 12 years was the wait, but it was worth it tonight. Fantastic scenes here at White Hart Lane. The aggregate score for the record is 6-3. Spurs are Cardiff bound. Not many Spurs fans have left the ground. Well, these are scenes we'll be remembering for a long time to come. Just for the record, Steffen Iversen got the opener on 2 minutes. Tim Sherwood doubled the lead as Hoddle comes out to salute the crowd. Sheringham got the perfect start to the second half on 50 minutes. Simon Davis made it 4-0. Rebrov 5-0 before Forsell got a consolation goal for Chelsea. It's ended at White Hart Lane. Tottenham 5, Chelsea 1. The aggregate score is 6-3.